Before you start working on your next big idea for XR in your business use case, maybe based on hype marketing that people just tell you that doesn't make any sense, or something that is just technically not feasible yet and just waste years of your life, let me show you 12 use cases in around 12 minutes that have been working, that are mostly industry independent and really important, that actually drive value in the business market. And if you don't know me, and why should you even listen to me? My name is Dinesh. I have been working in the XR field for almost a decade now. We work with companies in XR like Meta, but we also work with enterprise partners like Puma, Cupra, Zalando, and more, and really bring our community and these companies together. Additionally to that, I'm also a public speaker on this topic. I consult XR and non-XR companies, and our flagship event, XRCC, our hackathon, is bringing enterprises and our community together to really showcase and to really push the boundaries of what this technology is capable of. And again, always with the spirit of XR is more than just games and big screens. But now, enough of the intro. Let's get started right away. All right, let's start with healthcare. Healthcare was actually my very first use case that I've been working on as a developer back in 2017. Back then, we used it for stroke therapy, basically as a research project with a Technical University Berlin. I won't get into too much detail here. I have a TEDx talk which covers all of the details about this project. But in general, healthcare can be extremely interesting for this technology, just for the training also, but also for the people using it. So effective for therapy, rehabilitation, we have been showing that also. So, and there are a lot of uncovered use cases that are still very interesting. But here, the dangers, be really careful, like fake marketing and like some bullshit stuff is really high in this field, like stuff that doesn't make any sense. Like anything in direction of like real surgery with XR, you gotta be very, very careful. You've gotta really see, like, does this even make any sense at all? And most important in this field, is this goes for every field, but really for healthcare, work with freaking doctors. Like, I see a lot of companies not working with doctors, and work with doctors, work with the patients, work with designers, because usability is also extremely important in this field, because most of the time you have people who are like half blind or who can't move their arms anymore. So if you have like super high fidelity hand tracking built in because you don't talk to your users, it's kind of ridiculous, of course. Shout out here to Shift Medical. They have a medical congress on bringing healthcare professionals and developers together to really create use cases that actually make sense. Again, they're not sponsoring this or something like this, but Lars and the team, they are doing an amazing job. And really be careful not to fall for the trap of hype marketing. But still, this is something where there's a ton of opportunity to really do good with XR. Next, we have VR training. I always say VR training is the holy grail of XR, honestly, because this is just something where, especially VR, is just so much superior to any other medium, to be honest, because you learn best by actually doing something, whether it is like dismantling a machine or like doing some repetition with the hands or something like this, or even like step-by-step stuff that you need to do. This is extremely powerful. There is this use case with VR vision, for example. They have the Toyota onboard and training in multi-user, which is extremely interesting. Again, I will not go into too much depth into this. I will link a bunch of videos later on. But in general, with a VR training, especially if you have large companies, so like bigger enterprises, when you need to train like tens of thousands of people simultaneously, maybe even across different locations, you can't not think about VR training for this use case. Like, the ROI benefits are just so, so, so obvious. The things where you need to be careful is, again, this is some use case that applies more to larger enterprises, because the initial costs of building something are relatively high. Again, if you are a big company, like if you are in the 500-600 plus people or something like this, like if something like 100K investment doesn't kill you or something like this, then you will see massive ROIs. But if you're still like 10 people, then of course this might be kind of tricky. These are some things you should take into consideration, but otherwise, this is just a very strong, proven, phenomenal use case for pretty much any industry. Next, we have education. Something I'm very passionate about. It's just so freaking difficult to navigate in the field of education. It's just so complicated. I won't get into this too much, but you really learn so well. Like, imagine just like being inside of the body and like being in the blood cell and seeing like how everything flows, or like having the brain like visible to you like this, or like shrinking to the size of the of a cell to be in the human body, or at the same time being so giant that you can have the solar system in your hands. You can really feel it. You can have have interactive things with like the periodic system. You can visualize math. It is just unbelievable how many amazing use cases there are. The challenges here, to be honest, are definitely the cost of the hardware, like rolled it out to an industry that just doesn't have any money, honestly. And be very careful with like use cases where you tell your students or like the kids to use their own phone, because this makes it really difficult. Like, it looks good on paper, like everybody has a phone already, but like compare somebody who has like the latest iPhone and somebody who has a freaking Nokia brick. Like, how the hell does that work? Another thing is also it invents and really invites people to, or the students, the children, to just one swipe away and be on TikTok all the time. So there are like a bunch of things that you need to be really careful with. So always have smaller pilot tests before you enroll something very big. But I really see the future of education. I also have a talk about this again. I will just link them. It's just phenomenal, actually. Now we have a use case that is talked a lot about in this industry also, which is also very powerful, which is remote collaboration. This is just so powerful because you can work, really like feel like you are sitting next to somebody, even though this person is like 10,000 kilometers away. Like, you could be sitting in Berlin and the other person could be sitting in Asia and the other in America, and you like all work together on this shared blueprint, on this product, on this whatever it is, or this interior design. It could be anything, really. And this is just extremely powerful. You can save a ton of travel costs also with this remote collaboration, especially in a time with remote work. It's just like something that I think we will see more and more. The challenges here are the technology adoption. Like, always have an option for people to opt out so they don't have to use the headset. They can still do the same experience in the browser, because maybe you don't have like 25 headsets laying around. So really, like, this whole inclusion thing would be really helpful. Some people are like very sensitive in wearing headsets because like their fancy haircut will get destroyed. You see all kinds of stupid reasons. So try to onboard all of the stakeholders, have proper education, and then this is a great use case. Next, we have virtual prototyping. Again, something that is just like a classic for AR and VR, which I always talk about. My favorite use case to talk about, maybe I should find others also, is Bell Helicopter, because they could just like save massive amounts of time of developing the helicopter they had, because they designed it in XR, they designed it in VR, and they could shrink down the time from multiple years to several months. And this is just, think about the amount of iteration and time and cost that you have saved with this use case. And this is something that we have developed for multiple clients also, just because it makes so much sense. But I will talk about this exact use case that we have built in a later one as well. So the other use cases, they are also like super interesting, because they will be showcasing a lot of like big picture ideas about this technology. So definitely stick around. Next, we have real estate, and this is something that was like one of my very first ideas back in 2015 or something like this. Hey, let's build a real estate VR thing. I think like a lot of people have been thinking about this, but it's also so powerful, because imagine you can really virtually showcase your whole suite of apartments. Like, maybe rich buyers, they don't have the time to see everything like in physical, and you can really showcase this on your website already. This is slowly being developed, but there's much more potential than just stupid 3D like 360 videos. Not stupid, but you know, like, in having it in VR, six stuff and everything, like walking around, even interacting with these things, they just add another layer of interactivity and kind of like excitement also. It is just like the challenge here that these 360 videos, they just work natively in the browser. But yeah, still, like, WebXR is definitely something that can be extremely interesting, especially in combination with real estate. But otherwise, I think the whole like infrastructure, the system, how you have like hundreds of rooms or houses that you do scan, and how do you show this to your clients? I think this is something, there is a lot of untapped potential yet, but again, let's see what time tells. So now we have product showcases, and product showcases are also really good. We have worked with multiple companies that have done this also. There are so many benefits. Just imagine any product that is, first of all, very tiny. Maybe you have like something that is like an atom big, and like, how the hell do you show this? Like, I don't know, if you're like a screw, like, oh no, look at this. But you have a lot of stuff inside. You can zoom it out, you can see it in big, it's really cool. But the other way around, also, you have like massive products, like very big, large products that you don't want to carry on all the time, or even a freaking large factory. And there are a couple of use cases. Again, we work with one company that had like these machines that they wanted to show to customers also. Lufthansa also had this product showcase where they had these business seats that helped to save them 80% cost on not having to physically assemble the seats at the conference and fairs all the time. So according to the study, and that was also really powerful here. Again, here, think about the production cost initially, like why do you actually want to virtualize your product and then showcase it? Is it necessary or not? And then if it is, then you can reap massive benefits also. Interior design is something I'm super passionate about. This is my last company before I went all-time entrepreneur, basically. It is just so cool. We did this with offices and kitchens, but just imagine being able to lay out your whole room in XR and then just snap it with a snap of a finger. Yeah, my snap kind of sucked because I'm super sore from bouldering. But I just imagine you can change it in a second and really like see different scenarios. That is like one of hundreds of reasons why this is amazing. Because like, just compare like a freaking scribble that you have of your new kitchen that you want to build versus a photo versus a 3D rendering, for example, on the web, like IKEA does. But then actually being inside the kitchen, having a AR, VR, MR headset, and being able to like kind of like open and get a feeling for the spacing and everything, to really have a true what you see is what you get. And we had massive our eyes with the customers that we had. Like we were selling this to kitchen resellers basically, and they could sell more kitchens at higher prices with more satisfaction. It was just like unbelievably powerful. And this is something I still haven't seen too many people using, but there's a nice opportunity. Now we have showrooms. Showrooms is showing off basically. That's kind of what showrooms are in my opinion. We had a customer that had like fancy intelligent lights, like very expensive lighting systems, I guess. And they had a showroom. They had, we built a VR installation. That was my first like bigger project actually, which was not a research project, where we had like 6 headsets simultaneously running a virtual showcase of their vision basically. They're kind of like a storytelling kind of project, but you can combine this with a lot of other use cases, because imagine you have a bigger company or any kind of showroom, or like even a freaking museum or an exhibition, and you can show interactive experiences, you can show your products, you can showcase the layouts of this thing. Like you can kind of like integrate a lot of other projects, other products also into this idea. But having a showroom is really good, because showrooms usually want to have like a flash effect, like wow, this is amazing, you guys are so innovative and so cool. And at least back then in 2017 when we built this, actually worked. We have like all of these like stiff seniors, like Germans, going there, and then they put on the headset and they were like, wow, this is so cool. And yeah, it actually exactly fulfilled its promise. So that is definitely something, like if you want to have an emotional experience, that can be actually really cool. Which leads me to the next point, immersive storytelling. So that was basically what I just talked about, the emotions. Emotions are so much stronger in VR. Like you can have really insane embodiment, immersiveness in this medium, basically.
PETA, the world's biggest NGO for animal rights, wanted to change their communication from in your face to face to face.
Hallo.
Through a unique experiment that combined virtual reality with live acting.
Isst du Tiere? Mach's gut.
We put real emotions into a high-tech medium.
Nicht schlecht, der war gut, ey.
Making people rethink the way they treat animals.
You can really like truly change people, like showcase a different perspective rather than just like reading a story about it, or like watching a movie about it. Like you can be inside of this, and this can really change how you think about anything. Like you can really use it for like good stuff. I mean, unfortunately also bad stuff, but I think the benefits are that it's so unique and so interesting, and definitely like an area where I want to tap more into, because I think this is so fascinating. Because yeah, I love storytelling, I love immersive technologies. Those two together can be really powerful. You see a lot of that in like art exhibitions or like festivals, like tech festivals, or like something like Immersive Tech Week, where they have like a dedicated space for immersive storytelling, which is really cool. Shout out to you guys, by the way. Really cool conference also. And this is something where I think there's a lot more potential and a lot more use cases that can be explored. Next, we have sports. So Puma built the smallest XR fitness studio in the world with a collaboration with Meta, which is pretty cool. But there are so many freaking awesome sports use cases. I just love actually using XR for sports. This was also one of my ideas that I wanted to do before I went full-time content creator and educator. But just imagine like playing just alone Beat Saber on like expert is like, man, you really start sweating. And there's like things like FitXR and so many other sports companies. And I think this is truly amazing because you can do something that most people don't like, which is like exercising, and make it in a fun way, like having it in this medium. And gamifying something positive is always amazing, which is why I just love this use case. I love to explore more. If I would have more time, I would also do more of that stuff, but I already go to the gym, so I'm out of the target group maybe, but still amazing use case, a lot of untapped potential. And I'm pretty sure, trust me on this one, this will age well. There will be coming dedicated sports headsets. I think there were some rumors already, but like there will be like different XR devices, headsets for specific use cases. And there will definitely be coming something for sports with like extra accessories, cool stuff. I think this is like a really interesting industry to check out also. Puma, by the way, one of our sponsors at XRCC, so they also checked out some cool things. So shout out to you guys, really awesome. And of course, like they are really like pushing innovation forward with like showcasing and exploring all of these interesting use cases. And finally, we have retail / e-commerce. And also here, there's just so much you can do with like virtual stores, increased accessibility. You can have like even like a virtual closet, which gives you like AI-based clothing suggestion that you can buy immediately. Virtual try-ons is a huge thing. We worked with Zalando, who was also a sponsor of XRCC, by the way, on trying out some different ideas on what you can do. A couple of friends of mine or colleagues of mine built some really cool things in Zalando or on the Zalando track at XRCC, which is pretty cool. We'll just show it here. And there's a lot of interesting opportunities, especially in e-commerce in general, because you can just visualize all of these products. It's already being used, but I think there's still a lot of room to explore. All right, now we talked about XR business use cases. Again, if you are interested in any of that, if you need our help, if you want us to promote your stuff also, check out the link in the description. We can work together. We have a lot of cool stuff with the XR community, so we can help you land a job also. And we also do a lot of stuff with enterprises. So if you're interested in that, feel free to check the link below. Now you know a lot of foundational things, but you really need to know how actually VR and AR help to solve those problems, like what are the USPs, and really important. So we have this video here that explains all of that. So check out this one next and see you in the next one.